Welcome to an example that will show the relationship between performing stick multiplication and finding the partial products of a given product. We want to find the product of 131 and 142. So we'll first perform stick multiplication, where each green stick equals 100, each green stick equals 10, and each blue stick equals 1. So to model a 131, we would have one orange stick for 100, three green sticks for 30, and one blue stick for 1. Here we have 131, and now we'll model 142 in a different direction. So we'll have one orange stick, four green sticks, and two blue sticks. So again, we have 100, 40, so 10, 20, 30, 40, and two blue sticks for 2. Again, we have 142. The intersection points represent our product, where each intersection point of two oranges represent 100 times 100, or 10,000. So notice here we have 1 10,000. Each intersection point of an orange and a green represent 100 times 10, or 1,000. So notice how we have 1, 2, 3, 4 1,000s, or 4,000. And here we have 1, 2, 3 1,000s, or 3,000. Next, each intersection point of an orange and a blue represent 100 times 1, or 100. So here we have 1, 2 100s, or 200. Each intersection point of two greens represent 10 times 10, which is also 100. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 100s, which would be 1,200. And notice how this intersection point here also represents 100. Next, each intersection point of a green and a blue represent 10 times 1, or 10. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tens, or 60. And here we have 1, 2, 3, 4 tens, or 40. And then finally, each intersection point of two blues represents 1 times 1, or 1. So we have 1, 2 ones, or 2. Which means 131 times 142 equals 10,000, plus 4,000, plus 3,000, plus 200, plus 1,200, plus 100, plus 60, plus 40, plus 2, which equals 18,602. So 131 times 142 does equal 18,602, but these values here that we see in our stick multiplication are the partial products of this product. To show the partial products, we can write 131 as 100 plus 30 plus 1, and we can write 142 as 100 plus 40 plus 2. And now to find our partial products, we would perform repeated distribution, meaning we'd first distribute the 100, so we'd have 100 times 100 plus 100 times 40 plus 100 times 2 for our first distribution. 100 times 100 is 10,000, which we see here in our stick multiplication. Then we have 100 times 40, that's 4,000, so we have plus 4,000, which we see here. And then we have plus 100 times 2, that's plus 200, which we see here. Now we would distribute 30, so we'd have 30 times 100 plus 30 times 40 plus 30 times 2. So 30 times 100 is 3,000, so plus 3,000, which we see here. And then plus 30 times 40, that's plus 1,200, which we see here. Then we have plus 30 times 2, that's 60, which we see here. And our last distribution is to distribute the 1. So we have 1 times 100 plus 1 times 40 plus 1 times 2. So 1 times 100 is 100, which is here, plus 1 times 40, which is 40, which is here, and then finally, plus 1 times 2, or plus 2. So these are the partial products of our product, which we now know would give us a sum of 18,602. So not only is stick multiplication a nice way to visualize a product, it's also a nice way to show the partial products of a given product. I hope you found this helpful.